डिपेंड्स
It depends on in his surroundings.
on surroundings means
What he sees,
like
what he observes in his surroundings, things and objects.
observation means observation is, can be done through
Maybe
eyes, ears, like that, right?
yes.
the parents may say, sir.
Okay, they'll show him one dog and they'll simply say this is a dog, like that, right?
Yes.
And they'll show some cat and they'll try to say this is a cat, like that. Okay, that's fine. For example, they showed that cat or dog for 10 times, roughly. For example, 10 different cats or 10 different dogs. And they told to that kid, like, this is the cat, this is the dog, like that. Suppose one new dog came, that 11th dog came. Do you think that kid can recognize that 11th one as a dog, or he won't recognize?
Yes, sir. He can recognize.
He didn't see that. See, he didn't saw that dog earlier, right? How he can say that's a dog?
By its appearance, sir.
By its appearance, that means what that kid is doing within his brain or processor, what he is doing.
He is recognizing dog
Analyzing.
patterns.
He is
Analyzing.
storing the patterns, sir, whatever the dog structure.
Okay, he's trying to store that pattern of that dog structure, right?
Yes,
He's
sir.
trying to remember that pattern, but not pixel by pixel in that particular image or in that particular scene. He's trying to store the pattern, right? Something related to boundaries or some features. Like the dog has four legs and something like that, right? He's trying to remember such features. And based on that, he trying to recognize the new dog or new cat, whichever came in front of him. In that way, he will do, right? That means by default, he trying to have that pattern recognition capability, right? He trying to extract some patterns from the scenes, if that is visual task, and he trying to apply to new things, right? That's what he is doing. Can you say some sort of similarity measure? Its similarity?
Yes, sir.
Based on some sort of similarity measure, he is doing this, right? That means by default, your brain is trying to do some mathematical calculations about similarity. By default, you should do some mathematical operations, right? To know whether those two are similar or dissimilar, like that. And that kid don't know what is mathematics also, right? At that age. Then how he is able to do?
Brain is capable of doing those things.
Unconscious, right? Is he conscious or unconscious in that case?
Unconscious.
Like unconscious, right? Because he don't know the basics of math. How do I add 1 + 2? How to subtract? 2 - 1, nothing, right? You don't know what is the definition of mass outside that A. But still he is able to do. The reason is this only, right? You might heard about the Darwin, right? Evolution of that brain or everything, these things. From
Yes.
there you can get. By default, he is able to extract the features, that habit is there from the childhood onwards. No need to learn that mass perfectly. By default, they are having that capability inbuilt. Unknowingly, you can say like that. Okay, that's fine. For example, there is a wolf and there is a dog. Do you think that kid can differentiate both?
No, sir.
Why?
Most of the features are matching.
Most of the features will be matching, right? That visual features, at least. That visual thing. What? Yeah. How can you differentiate between dog and wolf?
By
the sound they produce, sir.
Sound.
Okay, sound. One way is sound, right? The sound might be a bit different, right? For both of them.
Tail.
Yeah, that's fine. Now you can think. This sound is one more feature, right? That visual thing is one feature. That you are trying to extract sound features also, or sound patterns also. With the help of these two things, you are able to guess whether that is wolf or a dog, right? With the help of extra features, that sound added feature, right? For example, you train that kid with dog pictures and with dog sounds. Can he separate dog from wolf? Is it possible or not?
Yes, sir.
It's possible, right? Earlier, he will feel like that may not be dog. He may not guarantee. It might look like dog, but that might be something else because that sound is something different, right? This is called a generalization capability. Some sort of inference he doing, right? He trying to apply his knowledge gained from the past experience. That's what he doing. He trying to guess something. He trying to infer something, right? From the knowledge. Learning, the true meaning of learning is that only. First, the kid will try to acquire some knowledge from the environment. Environment might be from mother or father or from the world itself. And after acquiring that knowledge, he will try to apply that knowledge somewhere, right? He will try to infer that one. This is called as true learning. You can see the definition of this one. In cognitive science, learning is typically referred to as the process of gaining information through observation. That kid will try to learn the things from the observation only, right? Yeah, if you want to get the clarity. Let's try to imagine a hypothetical scenario where you kept that kid in a forest where there are only animals. There is no human being. Do you think that kid can learn how to walk with two legs?
What no, sir.
Yeah, what he can do?
He'll walk. He'll learn by seeing animals.
Yeah, how he'll walk? Will he feel like he's having two legs? Or will he feel like he's having four legs?
Four legs.
He's having four legs, sir.
He'll feel like that, right? He'll feel like that. He will never try to stand with two legs, right? Because most of the things they'll try to learn from the observation only. That's the learning stage, right? If some people are walking with two legs, they'll try to imitate that one. They'll try to stand first. After that, they'll try to walk, right? Through observation. Yeah, that's why this definition came. They can learn through observation, right? These are the types of human learning. This is one type. Learning under expert guidance. Can you give me an example for this? Learning under expert guidance.
Gym, sir.
Okay, that's fine. They will try to train driving. And try to follow the instructions, right? Okay. Yeah, what else?
Sports.
Sports. Yeah, that's fine. Okay. At least up to some part. I can't guarantee that the entire sports corresponds to learning under expert guidance. There is self-learning also, right, in that? Is there any self-learning involved in sports?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. In anywhere also, sir.
See, for example, yeah, you just consider some sport, any sport, and if your guide just instructed you, like, try to apply this much amount of force in this particular direction so that you can get a goal like that. Do you think you are going to exactly apply same amount of force in Newton's and in the same direction? Is it like that?
No, sir.
You can't do that, right? That's not possible. They can guide you up to a certain level. After that, you need to learn by yourself, right? You should go for self-learning. That is through experience, through your own experience, right? This combination of both. And the second one is learning guided by knowledge gained from experts. You'll try to gain some knowledge from experts. After that, you'll try to apply that one somewhere else. You'll try to make use of that knowledge and you'll try to extract more. Third one is learning by self, by yourself, from your mistakes or from your experiences. Here are the three major learning mechanisms for the human beings. In a similar manner, we'll try to have machine learning algorithms which will try to imitate the three mechanisms. The machine learning algorithms are the pattern recognition algorithms. It's a definition of machine learning or pattern recognition algorithm. That's a computer program is said to learn from experience with respect to some class of tasks and perform and performance measure P. If its performance a task T improves with experience E. Can someone explain this? You are able to see this slide, right? So this is something like learning from experience, right? For example, if you consider the task of cycling or playing chess game. Consider the task of playing chess game. If it keeps on improving as you're playing more and more games, then you can say that's a part of learning. That's a learning process, right? If you're not improving, even if you play 100 games or 1000 games, that will not come under learning, right? You should try to learn from your experience. Here, the task of playing chess game, that performance keeps on increasing as you play more and more games, and if you learn with your experience, right? This is the difference between traditional programming and machine learning. Well, let's go to the pictures. This. Yeah, at least you might have seen this, right? In electronic devices and circuits course. What is this?
Forward bias VI characteristics of diodes.
Okay, that's fine.
Like,
for example, these are your observations. There is some dots, right? Some cross marks somewhere. These are your observations. You are trying to change the forward bias voltage. And you are trying to find the constant current through that one in milliamperes. Like this you are finding. There are some blue color cross markings, right? These are your observations. Someone asks you to give the value of this current for this particular voltage. Can you guess that one? Is it possible without doing experiment?
Yes, sir.
How that is possible? You have only these observations. These blue color observations are there with you. Now someone asks you unknown thing. You don't know what is the constant value of the current at this point. And they ask you to guess what is that value. How to guess what is that value without doing experiment?
Draw the horizontal and vertical lines at which we want the values. So the intersection point will get
See, forget about this green color line. This green color line is not there. You have only these observations, blue color. And someone asks you to guess what is this value, this current value for this particular voltage based on your past observations or past experience. How to do? You can go for curve fitting, right? This is called like a curve fitting. You have x values and concerned y values. You are trying to find y equal to some function of x. You want to find that mathematical relation. Let's consider this is a mathematical relation we are expecting. What are the unknown things in this? See, your observations corresponds to V and I. These are your experimental observations, some observations. You know V, you know I. But you don't know what is I naught, and you don't know what is eta, what is Vt, right? With the help of these blue color observations, by using them, you will try to find the concerned I naught and eta into Vt. These two things you will try to find. These two parameters, unknown parameters. Once you know what is I naught and what is eta Vt, you can find the relation between V and I, right? I is function of V. Now if someone asks you, what is the value of I for this particular value of V? Then you can simply substitute this V into this expression, right? To get the concerned I. See, called as a model. It's a model for this particular task. With the help of this model, you can try to guess what is your I value, right? By using these observations, these blue color observations, you will try to predict what is eta Vt value and what is I naught value. Once you got I naught and eta Vt, then you will try to substitute V into this expression to get the concerned I. This is straightforward, right? This is called as a regression. Is a regression operation. You are trying to predict something missing, right? You are trying to predict the concerned I value for this. Yes, one of you can explain what you are observing from this.
Some pictures are given as input, and okay. Where in output we are get at the end we are able to predict the answer what kind of object it is.
Okay, that's what we are doing, right? This is like a classification. This is called as classification. What I classify the inputs. The meaning of this one is you want to see whether that is a duck or that's not a duck. That's what you are doing in this thing. It's a task. You want to identify the ducks in this one, and if that is not a duck, no need to identify them separately. You simply say this is not a duck. That's it. Yes or no kind of thing. From the images, you want to do this thing using some learning algorithm. You will try to first. You will try to train this learning algorithm, this machine learning algorithm or pattern recognition algorithm. With the help of duck images and other than duck images. They are the labeled one. You'll try to give this input to this algorithm and you'll try to say this is a duck. And you'll try to compare whether this algorithm is giving duck or not. If that is giving duck, you won't adapt the algorithm. If this is showing this is not a duck, then you'll try to update this algorithm, update these parameters in this. Similarly, you'll try to give this input, and if this algorithm is giving this as a duck, then you'll try to update the parameters in this. because your correct answer should be there should not be a duck, right? So we'll try to update the parameters, and after sometimes this will try to show it like this is not a duck. If this is showing like this is not a duck, then no need to update these parameters. Once you train this supervised learning algorithm with the help of these known tags, this is a new input. This is a new input, and it's able to predict like a duck. This is a duck, right? It's able to give the output like a duck. It's a supervised learning. Can you guess why this is called as supervised learning?
Because know what exactly output should be. Already we know what kind of output should be.
Yes. While training, what we are doing is we are trying to give some duck input, and you are saying that output should be duck. That means that label also we are giving to it, right? It's something like a parent is showing to kid like this is a duck, this is not a duck, like that. They are training the kid with some ducks and other than ducks also. They are simply training that kid. They are simply showing this and they are saying that this is a duck and this is not a duck, like that. Once you train that kid or that particular learning algorithm, your next step is you should generalize that one, right? Like the example that we have taken earlier, right? If you train that kid with 10 ducks, he can recognize that 11th duck without any doubt, right? He can try to generalize the things by extracting some features or some patterns. In a similar manner, this will try to extract the patterns in this one. This won't simply by heart this input. That will try to extract the patterns in these images, and this is able to frame a model. Whenever some new duck came, this will try to compare with that pattern. If that's nearby that pattern, this will try to give the output as a duck. If that's far away from this pattern, it'll try to give like this is not a duck. It's trying to do generalization, right? It's not simply by adding the things. It's trying to extract the useful patterns, and with the help of those useful patterns, it's trying to classify the things. And can someone guess what is this?
Some kind of pictures are given as a input, and same kind of pictures are grouped together at the output.
Yes, that's what you are doing here, right? And this is called as unsupervised learning. Can you guess why this is unsupervised learning?
Because we don't know what should be the output.
Yeah, that's the reason, right? See, in this past scenario, parent or someone should inform to that kid, like this is duck, this is not a duck, like that. In this case, do you need such training? You don't need such training, right? That kid can identify the similar objects in this one. These three are similar. He'll try to group that. But he don't know this is duck. At least he knows that these three are similar. Up to that, he can guarantee. But he don't know the name of this. Similarly, this is another group, this is some other group. Based on similarity measure, he is able to group them into different categories. But he don't know the name of them. Because no one told him, right? By default, he can do these things by himself. See, called as unsupervised learning, or this is a clustering algorithm. You are trying to form clusters. Three clusters are there, right, in this. Based on similarity measure. Yeah, what can you guess from this? Yeah, one of you can think and answer. What are you getting from this picture? Yeah, let me give the hint. For example, this person came to the shop and he bought these items first. The first person who came to the shop and bought all the three together. And he is the second person. He is trying to buy the two items. But what's happening here? Can you guess?
Both are similar.
Third item is also recommended.
What?
Similar mentality.
Okay, similar mentality, right? See, suppose this person bought all the three items together and this person trying to buy the two, then that shop owner will try to suggest this one. Like we have Coke also, if you want, you can buy this. It's a recommendation, right? The shop owner trying to recommend. It's better to buy the two along with this one. If he is of same mentality, he'll try to buy this definitely, right? That will give some profit for that shop owner. That's a benefit, right? Same thing will happen in online recommendation system. You can see, right? In the Amazon or in the Flipkart, if you try to search something, they'll try to give the consent accessories also, right? Suppose if you try to order mobile phone, along this one, they'll try to recommend some pouch or something else, right? That based on these observations only. They'll try to recommend relevant to that one, that's it. Even if you go to some supermarket or somewhere else, along with coffee powder or tea powder, just nearby that one, you can find sugar also. The similar objects, they'll try to keep side by side. Because whenever you look into this one, you'll try to come to know that I need this also. This is called as association. They can improve the business, right? They'll try to attract you. That's it. That's what they plan. It's a recommendation system. Okay, do you think this task is supervised learning or unsupervised learning or reinforcement learning? See, reinforcement learning means learning from mistakes. You'll do mistakes and you'll try to learn from the mistakes. That's reinforcement learning. Can you call it like a supervised learning? Cycling.
We cannot say, sir, because we take the mistakes into consideration and we will do not repeat that mistakes.
Yeah, I'll try to explain you what is supervised learning. Supervised learning means, for example, I am the trainer and trying to train that kid how to ride a bicycle. One way is I can say, just sit on the seat first. After that, keep your left leg on the ground and keep your right leg on the pedal. Up to that, that's fine. Supervised learning. After that, I'd like to say, try to apply 1 Newton force on the right pedal. After that, I'd like to say, try to apply 1 Newton force on the left pedal. And if you want to increase that speed, try to apply 2 Newtons force on this and related suppose on that one. Try that. If I give some physics, everything based on physics, right? I'll try to give all physics notations to that kid. This is some sort of supervised learning. Do you think he's going to learn that one?
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
Will he learn?
No, sir.
I'll try to say you should apply this much force on the pedal. Like that, I'll give some numbers in Newtons. Force in Newtons, right? And I'll try to explain him how to balance also. Try to apply this much force right side this much force and left side like that. Already give all restrictions. Do you think he is going to learn the things with this?
Obviously, he will learn, sir, if he can understand everything.
No, sir.
I think no.
No,
sir.
How he can learn?
He don't know physics, no, sir.
See, even if he knows physics, do you think he will learn?
No, no sir. He is going to learn only by his mistakes, sir.
He will learn only from his mistakes only, right? He won't learn even if he know physics properly. And if you give all physics terminologies to that guy, you will never follow that one. And it's not at all possible. It's very hard task. It's not so easy task, cycling. He will try to learn from his own mistakes. For example, he came near to that turning. And if he is going with very high speed, then what will happen in the turning, that road turning?
He may fall, sir.
Definitely he may fall, right? What is the reason?
Centrifugal force.
Okay, centrifugal force, right? Yeah, that's what, right? Centrifugal force. That's the reason he will fall down. Yeah, in general, how you are going to learn, like you need to slow down at the turning points, how you are going to learn in general, how you learned, you know how to ride a bicycle, right? Do you think someone gave you instructions straight away, like you should go with this much speed only, like that? Is it like that? Are you learned by yourself?
We learn by ourselves only.
You learn by yourself, right? From your mistakes. You might lose some balance, right? At least if you are going with high speed, you may not fall down most of the time, but at least you might lose balance. And from that feedback, you'll try to learn. Like I should, it's better for me to slow down whenever I came across turnings. In that manner, you try to learn the things, right? It's learning from the mistakes, from your own mistakes or from your experience. This is called as reinforcement learning. No one will give you guidance. You will try to do the things. And from that mistakes, you will try to learn. That's what you are going to do here. For example, yeah, just consider a scenario. Like if you simply say to a kid, 2 years kid, don't touch that one. That's so hard. Will he learn?
No, sir.
Why? Okay, or how he can learn?
Getting experience after getting a shock.
Yes, that's the only thing, right? He'll try to touch that object and he'll feel that heat. After that, he'll never touch that, right? From his experience only he can get. This is through self-experience, right? He can't teach everything to a person, right? There should be definitely some self-learning. You can't make it like complete supervised learning. It's not possible. Yeah, one of you can explain what you are observing from this picture. Is it a driverless car or autonomous vehicle?
It is a driverless car.
Driverless car.
Oh, that's fine. Okay, are you able to see this thing?
It is a lidar technique.
Okay, lidar, right? Why you require lidars? Lidar is some sort of radar kind of thing. You can feel like that only. Some sort of radar technology. But this is with light, that is with some other frequencies, that radar. That's with microwaves. This corresponds to light frequencies. Yeah, why required radar or lidars for autonomous vehicle? Then again,
to identify the other vehicles and their movements.
Other vehicles are objects in front of you, right? From the reflection property, that same thing, similar to radar only, radar technology. Even in the night time also, you can guess, right? With the help of this one, even in the night time also, without light also, you can try to find the objects in front of you, without any doubt, with the help of this technology, either radar or lidar. Okay, that's fine. Why you require cameras? If lidar is there, which can take care of everything, then why you require cameras?
To observe the traffic lights or symbols.
Yes.
Road signs.
In order to observe the traffic signals and something,
how much
the traffic signs like that, right? You require the help of camera. Without that, you can't do, right? Without the help of camera, just with the help of lidar or radar, you can't identify that whether red light is there, green light is there, like that, right? In that signals. You require that visual thing. You need to take the help of cameras, at least for that purpose, right? Okay, that's fine. Then why you require this one? There's something mentioned, right? In some GPS setup. GPS. Why you require GPS?
Location of car.
Okay, in order to know the location of the car, right? Okay, that's fine.
And even interacting between the cars.
Okay, that's also fine. Okay, up to some extent. Okay, for example, if you are going on a road and suddenly some tunnel came, 1 kilometer tunnel. The tunnel length is 1 kilometer. Do you think you are going to get GPS signal in the tunnel? Will you get GPS signal inside the tunnel? Is it possible?
Maybe no, sir.
Most you may not get, right? With high probability, you may not get. In that scenario, how they can manage? It's autonomous vehicle, right? With the help of Google Map, that can go from source to destination without any doubt. But if you found such scenarios, then what that can do? Any guess? For example, if you want to go from Basar to Nizamabad, suppose somewhere in between you lost signal, GPS signal for 1 kilometer, then what that can do?
Predictions, by predictions we can go for.
Prediction means, yeah, how that can predict? Yeah, one thing you can do is, that can pre-download that map, right? Map from Basar to Nizamabad. They'll try to download that directions, all that entire map. And they'll try to keep it in offline. Once it got downloaded, after that, what that can do? See, but that should know the current GPS location, right? Even though that downloaded that entire map, that should know the current location. How that can predict? Suppose up to this point of time, I know GPS location. And for the next 5 minutes, I won't have GPS location with me. That signal I lost. Then what I can do?
It can read the instructions at the roadside, sir.
It can... What can do?
Using camera, it can read. It will show like roadside, no, sir. The next destination is 5 kilometers.
Okay, that's one way. Another way?
With the speed of the vehicle, sir. How much distance it can travel in that
time? Yes, duration. That can do this thing, right? By default, that vehicle is having that speedometer and everything, right? The distance, how much that's traveled, everything. That can try to guess based on the distance, right? It know. See, it definitely knows that if that is going with a speed of 60 kmph for 5 minutes, it knows where that will land, right? How much distance that can go. That vehicle knows. Based on that, that will try to guess its current location, right? That can guess the current location based on the present GPS location followed by how much distance that's traveled along that particular direction. That's possible, right? It means that your autonomous vehicle should not blindly depend upon GPS. There should be some alternatives, right? If you are going for autonomous vehicles, you should not blindly go for only one method. You should try to switch over. If this failed, you should try to switch to something else. Such mechanism should be there. You can use LiDAR technology for predicting the obstacles. And you can use cameras also, if that is morning time. You can simply go for cameras, right? Anyone is fine for this, for predicting the objects in front of you. It's possible. If at least one of them is working, you can manage up to some extent, right? But in general, they will try to take the correct information from both, LiDAR and cameras, their final output. Yeah, can you just guess what you required here? I think you might heard about this, right? That Mars rover, they tried to apply artificial intelligence technology for this, right? AI. What they had done? At least you can think. For example, that came to that Mars somehow, that Mars rover. After that, you can see there are some obstacles in front of them, right? How that can cross them? There is no man, right? There is no person inside this one. This is something like autonomous vehicle only, indirectly.
There may be the infrared sensors, sir.
Okay. There might be some infrared sensors, like IR camera. And what else? It's almost imitation of this, right? You should try to imitate this, exactly. That's what you are doing here, right? You can go for LiDARs or radars, like that.
Even cameras for capturing objects.
Yes. It's almost like an autonomous vehicle once it went to that Mars, right? And this online recommendation system is a claim by Netflix. Over 80% of what people watch comes from our recommendations. It means that they are exactly able to predict your behavior, right? At least with 80% chance, they are trying to show you the proper results for you. That's the claim of them. They are trying to use machine learning algorithm there. It's something similar to that YouTube recommendation system that we had discussed yesterday. Something similar to that only, this one. They'll try to cluster or group similar mentality people. And based on that, they'll try to recommend you. Okay. That's fine. Let's go for discussions. Yeah, you can ask if you have any doubts.
So is the driverless Uber car is working in India? Is that?
No, no, that's not working. They are expecting by 10 years. See, the limitations of this one is that road tracking itself is a very difficult task. If you construct some foreign roads, at least in the movies you can see, right? They're almost, they'll always, there won't be any discrepancies in between, right, on the road. You won't find that many disturbances on the road. They are very smooth. That will follow some structure, right? All roads with some good markings. Can you find such scenario in India? Everywhere?
No, sir.
It's not possible, right? It means road detection itself is dangerous. Road detection by the camera system itself is not so easy task for most of the areas. If you are unable to identify what is the road and which one is not a road, you can't do good things with that, right? Forget about other things like recognizing people or those things. Just consider road. Road detection is not so easy. First, they'll try to apply in good conditions. If that got succeeded, and then they'll try to apply to such kind of hard conditions after rigorous training. It's not so easy actually. That's why in general people will try to go for semi-automatic. A driver will be sitting in the car, he'll try to drive that one. In that process, that will try to learn the things. That's the way they'll try to train. It won't blindly go and do the things. First, driver will be sitting inside the car and that camera will be on, everything will be on. They'll try to collect that entire road picture, everything. And you'll try to apply steering, right? You'll try to decrease the speed of the vehicle, everything. That system will try to collect the entire behavior of the driver. Whether he's increasing the speed, or whether he's going left or right, like that one. This behavior, and that will try to capture that frames or images of that road also, including pedestrians, that obstacles, everything. And they'll try to map if such kind of situations are happening, what I need to do. In that way, that will try to learn. If you want to train that autonomous vehicle in this manner, you need to roam around that entire country, right? You can find so many road structures, different things, right? Sometimes more traffic, sometimes less traffic, like this one. You need to train so rigorously. After that only you can go for this one. That's not so easy actually. You need to give rigorous training. Yes, any other doubt?
Sir, using AI, definitely we can decrease the accidents, number of accidents.
Yes, definitely it's possible. But see, one of the limitations I can say you is that GPS we discussed, right? GPS location. How much accurate your GPS will be? Can you guess? Current GPS.
Don't know.
It's roughly plus or minus 10 meters. That might be 10 meters left side, like a circle, 10 meters radius error, that much error you can expect with the current GPS system. Now you can imagine that with that much error, you can't blindly follow, right? Suppose your vehicle is unable to detect the road itself. You can see some roads looks like normal plane, right? Normal ground itself, some of the roads. And if your GPS is suggesting with 10 meter error, or for example, just 2 meters error, that might be at the edge of the road, right? As your vehicle is unable to read the road,
yes,
it will simply follow your GPS suggestion and that will fail, right?
Yes.
It's one other thing. If you consider ideal scenario, we can avoid that one. You can try to reduce the accidents. That's for sure, without any doubt. Ideal scenario means that road should be very proper, smooth enough, and there should be proper markings on the road, and everything should be ideal. Under ideal scenario, it's true. Even in the fog also we can do, right, with the help of radar technology. Suppose if you consider most of the accidents in North India, they are happening due to this bad light, right, in the winter season. That's the reason they made mandatory that light should be mandatory, right, for the vehicles. That should be on throughout the day. That's the reason they made it like mandatory. In such scenarios, humans will fail, right? Because humans will try to take the decisions based on their vision, whatever visible for them. But there will be some fog, right? In the fog, they can't identify the objects so easily. That's the reason for that accidents and such things. If you go for radar kind of thing, that can do well, right? Even though that vision is not proper, that can do very well. But there are some other limitations like GPS failure and something else, right? Yes. Yeah. What else? Any other doubts? You can ask, no problem. Okay, it's fine. Thank you.